Hello guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Minecraft with me, Tivek. Let's change this up. We're on episode 19. So, that's 9 episodes since that awful accident. So, last episode we did a bit of work on the frame quarry. I am going to continue with that today and see if I can figure out a good way to automate everything. So let me just clean up my inventory, and actually we're gonna head down again. And I'll get a few things built. So, be right back with you. So as you guys see, we have sort of run out of space to place more automated crafting tables, and thing is, I'm gonna need more. So, what I'm thinking about doing is expanding, really. Whoa, now this is a dangerous bug. It says that 47 pipes are connected, and this one as well. Which, as you can see, it closes that one off, and it pulses, and that's very bad. So, let's switch that one off, and that one off for a moment. See what happens if I do that. Yeah, I don't know why it's doing this. Maybe I need to upgrade my versions a bit. Not sure entirely. I want to check on this one as well. How many do you have connected? Just 2. You're fine. Yeah, so I'm going to see if I can find out what does that bug, and I'll be right with you again. Alright, so I couldn't find the reason why it did that, but I did a save and exit and went back into game, and now it's working. Yeah, if anyone knows what causes that bug, please let me know. Anyhow, yeah, before I run out, so I was saying I need to have a lot of more space for my buildcraft contraptions. So, I'm thinking that maybe I should build another crafting area here. Or rather, build it halfway down here. Since we have the crafting, the logistics system going already, might be a good plan. Or just use this area and expand it that way, which I think I will do, because I'm gonna need a bunch of new things. But that's gonna be later though. I'm going to start off by making a few things, so let me gather some materials and I'll be back in a second. I have just requested a couple of items, so here they come. A bunch of redstone keeps flying at me, and then we are waiting for a pair of silken bulls. Should be another one coming. Perfect. So I'm going to need my handsaw, oh I have it there, to cut up these into silicon wafers. Now I'm gonna need, for this first thing, I'm going to need 1 red doped wafer. Perfect. And I think I have the rest. Well, I'm gonna need to make a lime lumar. Okay, so let's see if I can remember now. It's like so, and wood. Oh, no, wait. I also need to make some ribbon cable. That one goes there. Wood like so, the lime lumer, and the red doped wafer. And we have a monitor. Awesome. I think some of you might have guessed what I am about to build. We're gonna need to have a diamond block. Let's just pull it out of here. Save me some time of crafting. And that's for the CPU. I think it's wood on top. We need more red doped wafers though. So let's do that. I need 2 more. And let's check the recipe for the central processing unit. Hey, I was on the right track. Wood around it, and then two red dope wafers. Perfect. Diamond block, ribbon cable, red doped wafers, and this. Now, I have no idea how this works. So, let's place it down and see what we can do. What happens if I start? Nothing. I don't know how this works. Let's see what happens though. Can I? Oh, I didn't mean to destroy that. I can destroy them and they don't go boom. That's good. I need a disk drive. So that's a blue electric motor. We know these. So let's grab one of these from our automated system. I'm also going to need to make another red dope wafer. And a ribbon cable I have. Where is the blue electric motor? Come on. I know you can do it. Perfect. So that was in the middle. That one was there. The red doped wafer was there, and then disk drive. Now we need to make a fourth boot disk. So let's grab some more wood. Let's make it 10. We need an iron ingot, and we are going to need a bunch more redstone. Oh, look at this. This is awesome. So the disk was like this. It's a floppy disk. Awesome. And then a fourth boot disk. So again, let's place down the CPU. And can I place the monitor on top? Yes, I can. And the disk drive just beside it. And the fourth boot disk is in. Let's start and see what happens. Mine OS. There we go. Awesome. It is working. Now I need also an IO expander. So bundle cable I have, ribbon cable I have, need a red dope wafer again. So let's make another one. Let's make that. Actually, let's make 5. I might need them. Okay, so ribbon cable and bundle cable I think I have in here. Yes, we only need one though. So we needed the ribbon cable, that one, and then just like so, we have an IO expander. I think I can place this one just here. Not sure. Not entirely sure. Let's place it like so and see if there are any. Yeah. So we would need to place it like that. So we have that one going out. Now, I'm gonna do the testing here. And I'm gonna let you guys see. Just because, yeah. Now that's the ribbon cable going out there. And just for the sake of it, let's place down that and that. Didn't I have a bunch of lights in the red power? Yes, I did. Perfect. So, if I understand this right, white is, well, give me a second. Yeah, that's bit 0, so that's decimal 1. Let's do IOX set, well, sorry, 1 IOX set. And that turns the lamp on. 1iox reset. Turns it off. Now, that's cool, but let's see how I do this. I would have to make it do that for a while. So I can't remember what the wait command is. Let's try 1iox set 10 tick. 1iox reset. I don't know if this is gonna work. Seem to work. Okay. So, now, if I could just remember how on earth I would create a new word. Yeah, I'm gonna have to read up a little bit on how to program this machine. So, in the meantime, let's pick it up. Oh, actually. Are we booted? Let's start it up. Let's see. Is it booting? There we go. Let's do 2iox set. Yeah. Awesome. So, I can pick this up now. I don't need the lamps. I don't really see a reason to use them. But who knows? I'm just looking here to see if there's anything I need. Well, I could carry the white insulated wiring with me. I don't think there's anything that I need right away. So I'm gonna head off to my rig and I'll be right back with you once I have arrived. Alright guys, so I'm back at the quarry and everything seems to be working as I think it should. And I put the computer here. So I got the disk drive here, and I got the CPU, the I/O expander with the cable plugged in, and the monitor. And it's loaded up. So let's see here now. White was the command to go up. Right now I can't go up anymore. And orange was down. Now, orange cable will be binary. No, it will be bit number 2. So if I do IOX set on that one, and we wait a second or two, then IOX reset. Should have gone down. Yes, it did. Perfect. So, now if I do 1iox set. Perfect. And we need to 1iox reset as well. There we go. And that's how easy it is to control the head. But let's define a few words that we will need. Let me think here. I will need to make a new word. Oh, sorry. 1iox set 20 ticks 1iox reset. That's the word that we're gonna be doing. And that should have gone, made everything go up, yeah. Let's do one for the let's try something. Let's make that command bore up. because that's the boar head. One IOX set, 20 ticks, one IOX reset. And that should create a word called boar up. And let's do one boar down. I made that uppercase because I wanted to. It doesn't really matter that much. And that should have created a word boar up and a word boar down. Now, let me try this out by doing three boar down. That's a long break. Is it done? Oh, sorry. Three times bore down. Is that not the way it works? Hold on a second. I'm just checking the documentation here. Okay, that should be the way to do it. It should be able to go down as well, I think. Yes, it should be able to go down. Maybe I need a longer break. So let's forget bore down. If we look at words, bore down shouldn't be there. Let's fix the other one as well, but forget bore up. And then bore up. Let's make it lowercase. You can do it this way as well. So one IOX set and let's make it 30 ticks. Yeah, 30 ticks. One IOX reset. And we save that. And bore down. Two IOX set. 30 ticks, 2 IOX reset. Now let's do bore down. Yeah, it did go down. And bore up. It did go up. Now let's do 2 times bore up. Don't know how many did go up. So it's all the way up now. Now how many blocks can we send it in total? Oh, stop it. We should be able to send it down 3 times and it will hit the ground. So if I do 3 times bore down, I don't know why that isn't working. Yeah, so I'm a bit of a noob when it comes to programming these computers. So there might be something I'm doing wrong here. I'm not entirely sure what though. So let's do 3 times. It does go down 1. Let's forget bore down. Let's do bore up a couple of times. And I should really move this computer to, like, here and have it so that I can see what I'm doing. Let me just do that real quick. Alright, guys. So, I finally figured it out. You need to have a tick at the end of the command. So, if you look at the last bore up here, I did one IOX set, 15 ticks wait, and then one IOX reset, then 5 ticks wait. That means that it will have time to switch off the signal and then switch it on again. So, let's do page to clean this up a bit. It's now as far up as it will go. So, just for charm, let's move this whole thing left. So that would be 4 IOX set, 15 ticks. Let's just make a word, shall we? Yes. Bore left. So that would be 4 IOX set, 15 ticks, 4 IOX reset, 5 ticks. And we save. And bore right would be 8 IOX set, I believe, 15 ticks, 8 IOX reset, 5 ticks. So if I type bore left, the whole thing will go left. Question is, did it have time? Let's see. What happens if I do 3 bore right? I need to check that it works. Yep. Bore left. Do I have one more? Yes, I do. Bore left. Okay, so now let's do 4 times bore right. Look at that. There's some blinking and some graphical artifacts there, but nothing major. So, now that I have these commands, it would be very, very nice to save them. So I've made a disk. Let's pop the fourth disk out and pop this one in real quick. And then do disk name quarry. I've already done this once, but let's do save. Let's see. Yeah. Like so. This will take a while. There we go. Now, if I understand it, I'll be able to save things. Be right back and I'll read up on that.
Alright, guys, I'm back in base again for a little, and I figured I'd finish up what I started with the equivalent exchange. So, I actually spent a lot of time waiting for my client star to recharge. I made an alchemy bag, another one, another ender pouch, which is linked to the home chest. And I spent some time down in the basement doing a little bit of reorganizing this. So this basically uses the AND gate in here, and these gates on these pipes here. So these will, when the inventory is empty, emit a redstone signal. So if both inventories are empty, I'm gonna take that water cell. I don't know why it's not pulling it out properly. Actually, let me check and see if I can. There we go. Maybe it works now. Yeah, so If both of these have an empty inventory, the timer will not run. That should save me a little bit of lag. There you go. And it stopped. And this one, it's the same there. It will switch off. And I closed it up with these. I also restructured this. So there's actually now... let me just see here. I need to have standard mode. There is actually an energy collector below here, which is powered, but that's only because of this block here. Well, not that one. This one. The relay, because it emits light. Very nifty, and that increases the speed of charging quite some. And believe me, to get 3.2 million EMC, it takes a while. Hint, I'm talking hours. So, I've made myself the red matter shovel, the pickaxe, and the hammer. Now, we are going to use these to make the red morning star, which is a combination of all these. Very, very cool. So, we need 6 red matter. This is the reason why I need the decline star fully charged. So, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it's almost empty. Did I get back? Okay. Yeah, might as well just stick it in here for a while. As you can see, this has been charging for like... oh, sorry. Yeah, a couple of minutes, and you can see how slowly it fills up. 3.2 million? Yeah. But 500,000 is good for now. I'm gonna let this one run. I can just go here and charge it when I need to. Let's craft this neat little item. So, we need the pickaxe, the hammer, and that one, and we'll just fill this like so. We have the red morning star. Alright, so I want to test this, but let's not do it here. I'm gonna go get... I got the client star, which has a little bit of EMC. As you can see, it ticks down slowly when you're flying, so... does use up energy. Be mindful of that. It can be very, very frustrating when you run out of energy. So, it did save me some space with these red matter items, though. I also destroyed the computer setup I had and decided to work on the caterpillar drive for my quarry. Alright, so let's find a place to dig a bit. Over there, maybe. What modes do we have? Mega Impact, Tall Shot, Wide Shot, Long Shot, Standard Mode. Let's do the Standard Mode. Charge it up. And just do... Oh, that's fast. If I right-click any vein, I should get that whole vein dropped on me. Yep, I got it. Also, right-clicking on dirt. Wow. That's neat. Now let me just grab these floating trees. Yeah, that left a bit of scar. But yeah, you get the point. It's a very, very powerful item. And, yeah, this is very cool. It's the same as Mega Impact mode. You destroy, much like a destruction catalyst. And it, I think it does the same, yeah, it does. So it's very neat if you want to level a mountain. So, yeah. I quite like it. Let's go for wide shot. There we go. Perfect. So, let's head off to the quarry that you can see up in the distance here. I've done a bit of work on it, though. Not a lot, mind you. Not a lot. But I have, as you can see, destroyed the computer. It's no longer here. Everything here is the same. I have... I wonder what that is... Oh, I know why. Huh. Yeah, let's do that. I'm gonna need to place that one there. Like so. Because... Okay, this is a nuisance. Let's dump all this dirt and this, and it should get sorted away automatically in my home. Brilliant. I might not have a destination for that. Let's check that battery. So, basically, I need a frame here. I got 64 frames there, so... that should move it properly. So this is a caterpillar drive. It moves this whole thing in all four directions. So it can now go left, right, forward, and backward. In addition to these pulling this one left and right, and that going up and down. Very neat. So... I'm gonna see if I can get some wiring set up for this. Not entirely sure how that's gonna work. But we are going to need... Let's start with the support frames and build out from there. I'm having a serious frame drop here. I hope that won't show too well on the... on the video. So, on these ones, we can connect. So let's say I have from here there should be good. Have I'm not sure how I'm gonna do this really, so I'm just improvising. Might need to modify it later, but basically now I have control of each of these frames. I'm also going to need to have delays and stuff. But I'm gonna figure that one out. Alright. So I'm gonna think a bit on how I wanna wire this, and I'll be right with you guys. Here I am crafting up a bunch of red power stuff. I need the pulse formers and some repeaters. And didn't I order toggle latches as well? I believe they might be taking some time. I don't know. I wonder if there is a way to see how many requests you have at the moment. I know there is an... It's not an analyzer, it's a red... Power, well, it's not a red power, it's a buildcraft tool. I think it's a monitor. A network monitor. 3 gold ingots and a gold gear. Let's get it. Because I don't think I have it already. Might want to check that. Nope. So... Let's see here. Network monitor. So I can see anything inbound? No. Okay, so... If I choose now to make... 3. Oh, I don't have any levers in the system.
I didn't know that I didn't teach that to my system. Let's craft up a bunch. There we go. Let's put that into the chest. As you can see, there is some overflow dirt that I haven't, that I totally didn't remember to put into the logistics chassis. I'll do that later. Let's do three of these. I have no inbound items. Down in this corner. Okay, strange. At least it said okay, so I'll wait for the items to arrive and I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back on site again, and as you can see, I wired up this one. This is the forward motion one with the gray wire. And I've started to prepare this little platform area. I need to make sure that the area underneath is made from covers so that I don't accidentally drag this into the ground and cause problems. Start pulling items from the ground, things like that. So, this is going to be sort of a complicated thing to build. And trust me when I say I am no good at all at doing compact stuff. So, if you think this is big and ugly, then I'm sorry. Just gonna have to live with it. But what I'm gonna do, I like to make sure that these are all... panels, and I have some more as well. So I move this one out so that the cable comes down like that. Cable is always pulled around on frames, and so are these little strips that I have there, because I needed to make sure it doesn't connect without a good reason to do so. Alright, so if I run the bundled cable up here, that should be all fine. And just because it looks nice, there we go. Okay, so the next one I want to hook up is this one, and that's gonna be the back motion for the whole thing. So let's grab the light gray wire. And this is the one that pulls... No, this is the one that pulls the whole thing. So this has to be triggered first. I wonder... Yeah, I'm gonna do it like that. Just because I like the way bundle cable look. Let's see. Actually, no. Yeah, I might be doing testing and stuff just to see. I want to do this. But first of all, we want the repeater. If I set it there, 6 clicks should give it a good timer delay there. It's the light gray we're on, so let's do that. Let's do that. Oh, I can't do that. This is gonna be interesting. I'd rather not move everything up. How about doing this? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is that what I have this one on? Yeah, I think so. I can run it up like this. then connect it there. And then I suppose I could run it. I'm gonna have to run it around. Like this. Put the bundle cable all the way up there because I need the space. And this one, I run there and up there. Now you see it connects all over the place. We put these cover strips there and there. And it shouldn't connect any longer. Perfect. I am relatively sure this should work. Why don't we test it? That's the reason why I needed the pulse formers, because I could test this with with the toggle latches. Let's put down some wire so I can see it. Yeah, there we go. I tried this with just the toggle latches, and that didn't work out very well. So that's the light gray. That's back. And next to it, we'll put this one and the dark gray. Now, if I flip this, it should go forward. And everything should go back where it should be. Awesome. Look at that. Let's do that again. You see, it pulled it forward, and then this one goes ahead. We could probably make this better. Let's check backward motion. No, of course not. I need to have it like so. And that should reset it. There we go. Much better. Awesome. So now I can go forward. I just want to make sure it resets. I come backwards. And everything is where it should be. Neat. Now I just need to hook up the other ones, which is left and right. It's going to be the same issue here with space, but I'll figure something out there. So I'll do that off camera and I'll be right back. There we go. It was actually a bit more compact than I thought it would be. Just going to clean this mess up a bit. We don't want it connecting from all around the place. There we go. Neat. Very neat. It could probably be made a lot more compact, and I might work on that at some point, but for now, let's test it out. So, the pink is to the right. So let's place down our pulse formers. There we go. And the toggle latches. There we go. Pink is left, and lime green is right. No, the other way around. Pink is right, lime green is left. So, pulsing this, it should go over to that side. Let me just check that everything is reset as it should be. And yes, it is. It looks all fine and good with me. I think. Yes, it does. And we can go that direction as well. Awesome. So, we have all the controls that we need. Oh, for those of you who might wonder why I used these toggle latches and pulse formers instead of just levers, it's because levers and frames don't coexist well. Trust me, it's very, very annoying. You put down a lever and it goes poof, and it's gone. So yeah, it kind of sucks. What I also need to do here, something I started back in base, but I'm gonna have to do that between episodes. I need a lot of solar panels. Basically, this one solar panel, which I don't know if it's actually connecting to that battery box there or not. What does it say? Let's yeah, I don't think it's connected. That's probably something that I need to check. Huh. I moved away the black hole band. That explains why things fall. Yeah, if I put that one there, and we can just grab some blue alloy wire. There we go. That should work. Let's test it. Although, let's not. Yeah, so I think that's pretty much it. It's a quite big, ugly platform, but it works. It's not too bad. I might end up closing it with frames or something and putting covers on it just to make it a big box sort of thing, but it doesn't really matter that well. So, I think maybe, let me just sleep and see if this rain goes away, and I'll be right back with you guys. Oh, the wonders of accidentally hitting stuff with your Morning Star. So, I just dug out a very nice hole here. And, yeah, I'm gonna use the Mercurial Eye to build this up again. But I have actually now managed to go over time by quite some. So, I'm going to call this an episode. Look at that. We got a nice little house again. And see all these things swirling around me? Let's it's a bit of a dangerous item to use. I'm not sure if I'm gonna continue using it full time or not, but yeah, we'll see. I am going to call this episode though, and in the next one I'm going to do more computer and get that one running so that we can actually program it to dig. And now that we have all the motion that we will need, that will be cool. So I'll see you in the next episode, guys. Bye-bye.